my era was the era of the Vietnam War. My father's era was the era of World War II. My uncle's era was the era of the Korean War. My grandfather's era was the era of World War I. Generation after generation after generation. War defines us, and fortunately, except we're in our very beginnings of our roots in America, we have not had war on our soil. We've not had enemy in our backyard. It's always been over there. There are generations who have no idea what war is, but there are generations of the 7 to 10% who were in the military. The title of my article is The Vietnam Memorial, Washington, D.C. I was in the Air Force. Never knew there was a ground pounding part of the Air Force. I worked with the Blue Berets, worked with the Green Berets. I was in Communications Command and Control. Oh, I should talk a little louder, okay. And I got to see a lot of things. My sons did 3 tours in Afghanistan. He saw a lot of things. My son-in-law did Iraq. Saw a lot of things. A lot of moral injury, soul injury, post-trauma, this, that, and another. Every war devastates the country. It wasn't until the families, several families got together and we went to Washington, D.C. Now, I've seen my share, but the starkness got to me. Fifty-eight thousand American military soldiers died in Vietnam. It is just a number, like so many other numbers, has no reference point, no connectivity. 58,000 is a fairly large number, but not big as numbers go. It means little to you without any life experience to compare it to, until you walk from the visitor center in the middle of Washington, D.C., about a mile to the Memorial Park in the sweltering heat and rain on a July day, which reminds you of a time before in the sweltering monsoon. The Vietnam Memorial is hidden from general view. Unlike other highly visible memorials, just follow the signs. Everything in your life is normal until you start to walk down the entrance sidewalk into a man-made hole in the ground. No one is buried here. But 58,000 souls spend some time here. As you slowly walk to the middle, perusing the many engraved names on the shiny black granite, the enormity starts to sink in. Names without faces, but family surnames and places you do recognize and understand. By the time you reach the middle, a thought starts to form in your head. Here, in this understated spot, represents the complexity and complexion of our joint United States of America National Heritage. It is a cross-section of Americana and our shared history of many cultures. 58,000 is the population of the memorial. 58,000 adult citizens qualify as an entire incorporated city. Not a town or a neighborhood or a township, but 58,000 is an entire bustling city. Multiply that by the average of 4 equals 232,000, and you have a very large and complex city. Then suddenly, poof, it is gone. But if you recognize the war was at least 3 generations ago, that number is now 14 plus million souls and families not born. Goodbye, New York City, all of Manhattan, Long Island, and parts of New Jersey. But that is the logical mathematician thinking. As you slowly walk up the slope from the middle, you might suddenly recognize a family name you knew from your town or city, or even a person that you actually knew. Now it takes hold. It's personal. There isn't enough time in your visiting agenda to read every name, but you don't have to. Now you get it. The Vietnam Memorial is also a place of healing, a place of personal closure, and a single point of inner contact. If you had been observant of the other people around you, you might have seen an old grandfatherly Vietnam veteran leaning out against the wall and crying his heart out. He is letting loose of almost 50 years of pent-up emotions and visions he really wished he never had. You might see a person or family rubbing a copy of the engraved name that was once a part of their life, a part of their genealogy. Others may be stopped in prayer for a particular soldier, or for all 58,000 at one time. Then there are the remembrance items, the pictures, the flowers, last letters from wives, kids, or parents, or even grandkids who never knew their grandparents. Then there are the other small items left behind by fellow veterans who survived walking through the same shadows of death and carry their own guilt. There is also the air of respect from the brotherhood of other veterans. This includes veterans who served in different branches of the military or in other wars. Veterans share a common bond that non-veterans have difficulty understanding. That is because they have not lived the experience. As you walk up the slope and out of the memorial, you notice the black panels are getting smaller and the columns are getting shorter. But each soldier's name, even the ones you didn't look at closely, takes on even more significance. And just like two vector lines converging into a single point of clarity and without fanfare, you are out. You may have taken another 20 steps before you pause. Then you look back for a final panoramic view of the sacred hollow in the ground with the black walls. It is then when you realize your life has just changed a bit, taken a shift in perspective. Everyone is is affected differently. Now the number 58,000 has a reference point, a connection. There is a personal feeling that goes with that number. That feeling will not totally change your life. You will continue on as before, just more aware, more knowledgeable, more human than you ever were before.